Well, welcome to Church Online. I am Xavier. I'm the assistant location lead for our Port Richmond location, as well as the youth director at the Block Church. And we're so excited today. I have the privilege and the honor to close out our series that we've been in, For God So Loved the World. And today is a special day as we're having service right here at Sunday Breakfast Rescue Mission. I got some of the audience with us today. And I'd love to take a moment and invite Jeremy and his wife, Erin, up. Jeremy is the CEO here of Sunday Breakfast Rescue Mission, and the work they do is phenomenal. They are helping walking men transition them from homelessness. They provide housing and food for them. Really incredible work, and I'm just so excited and thankful for the opportunity and the big work that's going to take place here as we're launching a location here in the fall right here, and so that's something to be excited about. And we've already been hosting services here, huh, Jeremy? It's been incredible. So, yeah, we love you. We're so thankful for who you are and the work to which you have invested and been all in on. And so I just wanted to tell you that. Thank you so much. Love you. Make sure you drop some love in the chat for Jeremy and Erin and Mix and Jess, who are going to be leading this location. It's going to be help leading here. Make sure you drop some love, some hearts in the comments in the chat. And it had me thinking with them being so committed and all in for the work that they're doing for these homeless men. It had me thinking about the beginning of this pandemic. And I'm sure a lot of you saw on social media what was trending for some weeks. It was called the all-in challenge, And if you didn't, essentially what this all-in challenge was there were these influential people, these athletes, these celebrities, giving away these super cool opportunities in effort to fundraise money to feed those who were affected during this pandemic. I mean, they were giving out super dope opportunities. I seen like Chris Pratt was giving out an opportunity for somebody to come be casted in and act on the new Jurassic Park movie they're making, right? How cool is that? I seen something where it's like you could go have a stay like in Hollywood, you know, and it'd be all provided for you. It'd be paid for. They could go eat dinner with some of these celebrities, right? All I want to let you know is that if the Block Worship had something similar right now, I'm telling you, I'd be all in for that, all right? If they were like, Xavier, we will give you an opportunity to lead worship on a Sunday. That's something I'm all in for right there. And yeah, it's just incredible work. But it made me think about when there is a clear cry for help from humanity, it really does take people who are capable and willing to make a difference. It really does. And I just noticed, you know, in this scripture, this theme scripture we've been going through, John 3:16, it says, "For God so greatly loved and dearly prized the world that he even gave his one and only begotten son, so that whoever believes and trusts in him shall not perish but have eternal life." And what's interesting here is that God saw that there was a clear cry from humanity. God saw that there was this brokenness, this cry for help, that we needed a savior. And so God decided that he would send Jesus, his very best, to be all in for the cause, that he was all in for humanity, and he bet it on Jesus. And I believe that God, in the same way as his heart was all in for humanity, he calls us and asks us as the church to be all in for people as well. So the title of my message today is All In. All In. You know, some of you may be sitting here and asking, you know, well, what does it mean, Xavier, to be all in? You know, that concept, all in. Well, the Webster Dictionary puts it like this. To be all in is to be fully committed or involved in something. So in other words, all of who I am, my time, my body, my mind, right? It's committed to it. It's involved in it. I'm engulfed in it. This is what it means to be all in. And that concept of being all in with all of who I am, this love of being all in, this sacrificial love of who I am, my time, my talent, my church, all this different kind of things it takes to be all in, it brought me to a scripture, a verse, where we see something similar of what it means to be all in with our love. And it's Matthew chapter 22, verse 36 through 39. And this is what it reads. It says, "Teacher, which is the great commandment in the law?" And Jesus responds, he said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the great and first commandment, and a second is like it. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself." So right here, they're saying, Jesus, what does it mean to really love? What is the greatest commandment that we're to carry out? And Jesus is saying, listen, if you want to carry out the greatest commandment, I'm telling you right now, you need to be all in on loving God and loving God's people. You need to be all in on loving God with your mind, your body, your soul, your heart. And the second is like it, to love your neighbor as yourself. And what's great and what's cool is the word for love that is used in these scriptures is the same original Greek text, the original Greek word for love that's used in John 3:16. It's agape love. And this is what agape love is. Agape love is the love of Christians for other persons corresponding to the love of God for humankind. It's unselfish love. It's not self-seeking love. It's sacrificial love. And there's no way you can be all in without being sacrificial. You have to be I have to give all of who I am, my heart, my mind, my body, my strength, to love in this way, to be all in this way. And this is what Jesus has asked us to do. In the same way that God sent his son as sacrificial love for us to be all in, we're called to be all in with the same kind of love for God and for God's people. And I want to touch on these three people group that I want to talk about being all in with this kind of love for today. I want to talk to you about the hurting, the hungry, and the hopeless. The hurting, the hungry, and the hopeless. The first, the hurting. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 3 through 4, it reads like this. It says, "Blessed be God, the Father, and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our affliction, so that we may be able to comfort those who are in any affliction with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God." In other words, in the same way, in the same comfort, in the same healing, in the same touch that we've received from God as we were hurting, we are to offer that same love, that same comfort, that same healing to those who are hurting, to those in the world who are going through it, to those in the world who are just in pain and in distraught. We are to offer that same thing. You know, growing up, I came from a single parent household. It was my mother and my three sisters, and there was no father figure around. And I saw my mom go through abusive relationships, physical, emotional. It just wasn't good, and it hurt me. It hurt me to see these things. I started getting into trouble. I felt like I had to fight all the time, and I felt like I had to be tough all the time because I was going through this pain, and I didn't know how to deal with it. I was just hurting. I was broken, and it hurt to see my family going through it, and I couldn't do anything about it. But I remember it as if it were yesterday. I ran into Pastor Joey for my first time, and he had invited me to come to youth group for free pizza and to play basketball, and I was already in at the free pizza. It wasn't nothing but a word for me, you know, but I just remember he invited me, and I was like, okay, this is kind of cool. The people are kind. They're loving. They're nice. You know, I was a little skeptical at first. I didn't know what was going on. They were singing songs to Jesus, right? I didn't have a familiarity with church, right? But one thing led to another. I kept coming back. And Pastor Joey and Pastor Lauren actually decided to start investing in who I was. And they would come pick me up for meals. We'd go to the movies together. I would just spend time with them at their home. And why I didn't recognize it then what was taking place, there was something that was going on the inside. And it was healing and redemption that was taking place in my soul. I didn't recognize it then, but what Pastor Joey and Lauren were giving me was the same in which they have received from God. That love, when they were hurting, that God would comfort them, that God would bring healing to them, and that in the same way, they now offered it to me. And I didn't recognize it at first, but that's what brought this healing. And then it led to me following Jesus, giving my life to Jesus, and here I am today. So I'm challenging you today that we have to be all in for hurting people. We have to offer the same healing, the same redemption to those to which we've been given. And here's what I believe. I believe there is healing and redemption that can take place for my family because I saw God do it in my life. And some of you just need to believe that today, that you are here as a testament of God's goodness, of his faithfulness, of his love for you. That yes, I was hurt, I was broken, but he redeemed you and brought you this far, which means anybody you know and love and see is capable of experiencing the same thing. And here's the thing. Pastor Joey and Lauren, they did it because God asked them to do it. They did it because they knew what it meant to be all in for people, for this love that calls us to be all in and sacrificial. They didn't have to buy me these meals. They didn't have to take me to the movies, right? They didn't have to spend time with me. But they were called and asked to do it, and it was a sacrifice out of their life because God asked them in the same way that God loved them and sacrificed. And so I ask you today, who is hurting that you need to reach out to? Who is going through it that you need to shoot a text to right now? Who do you need to take and buy a meal for and allow them to talk? Who do you need to just give your ear to that they can express what they're going through and they're just hurting right now? There's a lot of hurt in our nation right now. And I would ask you, who are you showing up for? And are you being all in on loving hurting people? Second thing I want to talk to you about is being all in for the hungry. All in for the hungry. I want to read this scripture to you. It comes from James chapter 2, verse 15 through 17. It reads this: if a brother or sister is poorly clothed and lacking in daily food, and one of you says to them, go in peace, be warmed and filled, without giving them the things needed for the body, what good is that? So also faith by itself, if it does not have work, is dead. Understand something. We can pray for people. We can love on people. We can speak life over people. We can do all these different things. But if our faith does not call us to action, then it's actually dead. If we don't put some work behind the faith that we claim, then it's actually dead. It will not bear fruit. Our faith should make us want to work. It should make us want to feel called to action. It should make us want to put it in movement. And actually today, you see this in movement right now. We are at Sunday Breakfast Rescue Mission. A true work behind the faith to which we claim. We believe not only in filling their spiritual need, but also their physical need. We are here helping. They are here helping transition those in homelessness to be able to move forward to what God has called them to and to do all these, right? So we're putting work behind the faith to which we claim. And while the body does have a physical need that needs to be met, we also are aware that there is a spiritual need that needs to be met as well. And so in the same way, when we're passing out lunches physically to meet the physical body, right, that need is in the same way that we're praying for those and we're filling the spiritual need. But here's the reality. We need to be all in for those who are hungry and meeting their physical needs and pointing them to the person who can meet their spiritual need, which is in the person of Jesus. And I'm just so blessed. I'm so thankful that we can be partnered with an organization like this, that our church is partnered with an organization like this who puts what they believe in practical movement. People and what they believe in helping and blessing those and transitioning those into their next phase of their life. I'm so grateful. And church, I'm asking you today, where do you need to step up and be involved in? How do you need to be all in on feeding the hungry? How do you need to be all in for the hungry? Like if it's you right now and you're like, I need to step up and the next time we have a Surf Saturday and we're going to feed people on K&A, or whether we need to go help feed the homeless, whether it's you saying right now and deciding maybe I need to volunteer here at Sunday Breakfast Rescue Mission, whatever the case may be, we need to be all in for the hungry. So church, I challenge you today, be all in with meeting the physical needs and also pointing them to the person who can meet their spiritual needs. The third thing I want to talk to you about is being all in for the hopeless. Being all in for the hopeless. See, we as Christians, we don't look to the world for hope in the way that we look to hope in Jesus. We don't look to the world in temporary solutions and fragile things that can break at any given moment. We look to the person of Jesus, the person of Jesus who is now and forever, who is sustained. We build our house on the rock where it is firm. And in church, we have a responsibility to offer this same hope, this hope that is unwavering, to the rest of the world. There are a lot of hopeless people in the world right now. In your sphere of influence, there are hopeless people. There are people who need to know the Jesus that you and I know. And I'm so thankful for the local church. I'm so thankful that the local church brings light and brings hope to our communities and to the world. I truly believe that we as a church, that we as Christians are the hope for this world. I believe that we extend that hope in which we have received from Jesus. I believe that we have an opportunity right now to offer that same hope, that same love. And I'm so thankful that our church, I heard a story earlier this week that within our block groups, there was this young woman. We have a young woman professional block group. And this young lady, she was in it. And in the beginning, during the pandemic, when everything was going on, where there was so much chaos and so much to be anxious about and stuff, she noticed that while she was at work, a lot of her coworkers were overwhelmed. They were just going through it. They were worried. They were anxious. And she noticed that she didn't have the same response to everything that was going on. Now, she didn't recognize it at the time, but while she was in her block group, she noticed that as the people were talking about Jesus, the other young women were talking about Jesus, she had noticed, wow, I didn't respond in that way because I have my hope in Jesus. And so she recognized for the first time that this hope in Jesus is just different than the hope of the world. It's just different. It feels different. It's not so easily moved. It's not so easily shaken. She recognized that my faith being in Jesus brought a hope that would keep me steadfast through the midst of everything that's going on. And see, she's a baby Christian and she recognized this. And I'm here to tell you today, church, that we have to offer that same hope to the world. There's a lot of people who are shaking right now with everything that's going on. And if it's not from the pandemic, there's a lot of people facing hopelessness in other ways. There are people in your realm of influence, where your work, who may be fighting depression, who may be having suicidal thoughts, who maybe they don't know where their next meal is coming from, or they don't know how they're going to make ends meet on paying their bills. Whatever the case may be, there's a lot of people who are hopeless right now. What are you going to do to offer that same hope to which you've received to them? And you'd be surprised at the outcome and the fruit to which people come and meet the Jesus, meet the living God to which you and I know. And I'm sure a lot of you are all in on some other things in your life. But we need to be all in on this hope to which we've received and offering this hope for the hopeless. Some of us, we've been all in on things that really do not matter in the long run, in the long scheme of things. We've been all in on social media, right? We've been all in for politics. We've been all in for a bunch of different things. But I'm telling you right now, we need to be all in for the things that matter, for the hungry, for the hurting, for the hopeless. We need to be all in for these things. We need to lay it all out on the field. We need to leave it all out on the field. My mind, my body, my soul, my strength, everything I have to offer is on the table. It's right here. Jesus, use it. Use me, God. There's nothing. And when we take this posture of saying, there's nothing in my life that is off limits, when we take this posture, we'll start to see fruit. We'll start to see things differently. We start to see where it goes from hoarding and insecurity to blessing and giving. We start to see where it goes from cancel culture to patience and forgiveness. We start to see where these preferences in my life start to become more mission oriented. We start to see all these, when things in my life are not off limits, when I am all in the same way that Jesus loved us, in the same way that God sent his son to die for you and I, in the way that he was all in with that kind of sacrificial love, God has asked us and called us to be all in with that same kind of love for people in the world, for the hurting, for the hungry, and for the hopeless. So church, what is it today in your life that you need to release, that you need to say, you know what? I'm going to give this to God. I want to be all in. I want to be fully committed and invested in. Have there been areas of your life where you've said, you know what, God, I don't know if I want to give you that. I don't know if I want to be available in that way. Whether it's your time, whether it's your talent, whether it's your treasure. God has asked us to be all in with that same kind of love that God sent for us, that same kind of love that God has for you and I. And today, church, I want to let you know that we have an opportunity to be all in for everything that I talked about. We can go all in with that same kind of love because Jesus has given it to us. And you may be watching this today, right now, wherever you're at, and you may not know what it means to feel this kind of love. You may have never experienced this kind of love that's all in for you. And I want to let you know that Jesus would have come and he died for you, that God sent his son to be all in for you, that although we were yet still sinners, that God loved us so much, he would send his son to die for you and I, that he would be all in for you and I, that that's how much he loves you and I, and that you have the opportunity right now. You have the opportunity to give your life, to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior, to go all in for Jesus. And so if that's you, I want you to go ahead and click the hand raise button right there. If that's you, if you want to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior, go ahead and click that button. And I want you to pray this prayer out loud as I pray it. Just say, Jesus, I welcome you as Lord of my life. I know you died for my sin and that you raised 3 days later. Father, I trust you. I give you my sin, my mistakes, and my life. I want to be all in for you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Come on, come on. Let's put our hands together. If you just made that decision right now, I want to let you know that that is the best decision you will ever make in your life. And we are so excited to welcome you into this family that is all in. And we have hosts in the chat right now ready to connect with you. You can hit that live prayer button. And we love you so much. We'll see you soon.